Greetings, pilots and passengers. Today I have a very interesting article about the past, going back a good few thousand years now. You know, some days you wake up and you think, can't we just go back for a bit to a time when none of this craziness was going on? Just see what it's like, even just take a time machine back for a day, just to be nosy. We're going to be looking at the Mayans, because it turns out they have actually used crystals as part of their everyday life, as part of purifying water. Yeah, it's been discovered that the ancient Mayans used quartz and other crystals to purify their water, and this was a working filtration system. And it's believed to be the oldest known filtration system of water that uses crystals. So this article is from Science News, but you guys know where I get all my news from. We go to Natural News. I love that site. But they had an article about ancient Mayans, and I think it's interesting because, as you know, I really like crystals, and crystals are just awesome. And to know that they're being used in ways to purify water in a filtration system as far back as the ancient Mayans, it says a lot. And you gotta wonder why we don't implement things like this now. Obviously, we just use chemicals now, which, you know, there's all sorts in the water nowadays. You're probably killing us off very slowly. The article says that ancient Maya used zeolite and quartz to filter drinking water. So Tikal, an ancient Maya city in what is now northern Guatemala, is one of the largest political, economic, and military centers of the pre-Columbian Maya civilization. The metropolis was inhabited from the 6th century BCE to the 10th century CE. And had a population of up to 90,000 people in its heyday. A large reservoir called the Corriental Reservoir was an important source of drinking water for the city. A team of archaeologists from the University of Cincinnati has found that between about 2,200 and 1,000 years ago, the drinking water in the reservoir was filtered through a mixture of zeolite and coarse sand-sized crystalline quartz. This filtration system is the oldest known example of water purification in the Western Hemisphere, and the oldest known use of zeolite for decontaminating drinking water in the world. I think it goes to show that back then we knew how to actually take care of our bodies and do such in a way that we're not using chemicals and things like that. Now look, I completely get the argument of like, well, back then we didn't know how to do things, or we didn't know this, but I think it goes to show that further back than we think, we had a lot more advanced technology, and I would say a more advanced understanding of the world in some ways than we actually do now. Or put it another way, maybe you could sort of also argue there are probably people who do know of more advanced technologies that we do have that we just don't have access to. I mean, I bring that up all the time, but it's genuinely what I do believe. So zeolite is a non-toxic porous crystalline hydrated aluminosilicate mineral with natural absorbent and ion exchange properties, which removes harmful microbes as well as dispersed insoluble and soluble toxins from drinking water. Approximately 2,700 years ago, Greek and Roman engineers used zeolites as a pozzolan in cement in the construction of large-scale hydraulic structures such as aqueducts, bridges, dams, and harbours. So it has many uses, it sounds like. However, it has been assumed that zeolites were not used for water purification until the beginning of the 20th century because scientists, archaeologists, whomever, have this, I think there's this sort of belief that all these thousands of years ago, we were absolute beanheads, as in we just didn't know how to do a thing. I think they assumed that we were just had nothing back then, had no understanding. We were very basic, I guess you could say. When actually, it turns out we're not. And I think a lot of people who are scientists or anything that goes against the mainstream consensus, I guess you could say, or understanding of how the world was back then, it's just not really accepted too much. We just still seem to have this idea that we were really dumb. That's just, you know, scratching the surface and summing it up in a very basic way by me. But I think that's what a lot of people seem to think, when it's just, it's rubbish. It has also been presumed that the oldest forms of water purification occurred in Europe and southern Asia. The ancient Maya created their water filtration system nearly 2,000 years ago, before similar systems were used in Europe, making it one of the oldest water treatment systems of its kind in the world, said lead author Dr. Kenneth Barnett Tankersley, a researcher in the Department of Anthropology and the Department of Geology at the University of Cincinnati. What's interesting is this system would still be effective today, and the Maya discovered it more than 2,000 years ago. So who's the dummies now, guys? Us. So here's an image you can see. This is the area they studied in Tikal, I think it is here. B is like where the reservoir is. I think that's the Tikal reservoir. All the areas, the Corriental reservoirs down here. There's a temple here. And C is the Corriental reservoir where they discovered the sediments, apparently. Dr. Tankersley and colleagues use X-ray diffraction analysis to identify zeolite and crystalline quartz in the sediments from the Corriental Reservoir. They trace these minerals to steep ridges around the Bajo de Azuca, about 18 miles northeast of Tikal. That's quite a long way away. It was an exposed weathered volcanic tuff of quartz grains and zeolite. It was bleeding water at a good rate, said co-author Professor Nicholas Dunning, a scientist in the Department of Geography and GIS at the University of Cincinnati. Workers refilled their water bottles with it. It was locally famous for how clean and sweet the water was. The zeolite filtration system would have protected the ancient Maya from harmful cyanobacteria and other toxins that might otherwise have made people who drank from the reservoir sick. So they understood that just, you know, pulling up and drinking water willy-nilly was just going to get you killed off. You know, we had smarts back then, and we used more natural forms. We're trying to get across that. Today we use, like, all kinds of chemicals go into our water, probably a lot that's not going to be any good for us. And back then we were using crystals, which had no real impact on our health. I would imagine it would be completely natural in a way. The ancient Maya figured out that this material produced pools of clear water, said co-author Dr. David Lentz, a biologist in the Department of Biological Sciences at the University of Cincinnati. Complex water filtration systems have been observed in other ancient civilizations, from Greece to Egypt to South Asia, but this is the first observed in the ancient New World, said Dr. Tankersley. The ancient Maya lived in a tropical environment and had to be innovators. This is a remarkable innovation. Is it an innovation, or is it just using, in a way it is technology still, to just using what we knew, what we knew of? A lot of people look at Native Americans in the Western Hemisphere as not having the same engineering or technological muscle of places like Greece, Rome, India or China, but when it comes to water management, the Maya were millennia ahead. There you go. He's just literally said it. People look at certain civilizations as just being inept, would be the word I would use. They just have this like bias that back then so many civilizations were just not with it in any way. So there you have it. It's just another example of the fact that we use a lot of technology back then that really benefited us. I think it's interesting to see that the Mayans were using crystals, because crystals can have many, many uses. Some people do believe that crystals, beyond their spiritual uses, I would say, can act as creating energy. Quartz itself is a very, very popular common crystal, as I've discussed before, that is primarily used for energy. But another use of clay quartz, for example, is purification. It's believed to clean and balance energies. So I guess you can see why they would use it. I love things like this. I love reading things about the past, because in my opinion, and it's one of those things I'm gonna say that I no doubt have said before, but really try and drive it across, is a lot of people assume that the way that history is a certain way because certain people have said it, that it is that way, if that makes sense. The history books are written to fit a worldview and a worldview of those who want it to be a certain way. They want the world to seem like it has been a certain way and will continue on a certain path, if you get my drift. But I think little nuggets like this go to show that what we think the world is and how we think it is really is not how it was, or, you know, how it is today. What do you think about the use of crystals as a water purification system? Do you think it's still being used today? Do you think we should be using it today? Seeing it implemented more often? Let me know down in the comments below. I really love reading your comments and everything you have to say. If you have any other articles that are quite interesting you'd like me to look over, please do leave them below, because I will always cover stories, topics, anything that you suggest. I'd like to say that if you'd like to support the channel, please subscribe to Dare to Fly Today and get ready to take flight. Turn on notifications so you get notified every time I upload a video. Like and share this video with others. If you'd like to support the channel even further, you can donate to my Ko-fi page or my PayPal, and links to both of those will be down below in the description box. I hope you all have a wonderful, blessed day wherever you are in the world. If you have some crystals, let me know what they are, because crystals are amazing. My favourite is amethyst. I love amethyst. Or rose quartz. Stay true, stay awake and stay blessed. And as always, fly high, fear less.